The next is the oldest piece of material I have. It was originally improvised on a suggestion from the audience on New Year's Eve of 1957. It has gone through many changes since. Even in my present delivery, I have inserted a line to assure animal lovers that the cat doesn't die. Has this ever happened to any of you? Or will it happen to any of you? On the morning after, the night before.
Oh, God. God. My tongue is asleep. And my teeth itch. Where is my Alka-Seltzer?
Oh, my God, don't fizz.
Don't be mean, Alka-Seltzer. Dissolve. Oh, the hell with it. I'll drink the pieces. Okay. Hail, Moscow. Oh, God. Oh, come on, God, will you? Oh, hello there, David boy. Hi, doing there, Dave. Dave, I wonder, you think you could whisper? Dave, this is me. It's me. It's your old buddy. Just a minute, Dave. Don't press me. Dave, if you nag at me, you'll never get it. Isn't that ridiculous? I just got a letter this morning. Do I sound familiar at all, Anna? You want to take a stab at a name? I don't know what letter it begins with. It's silly. I mean, I know my own name. I know it as well as I know mine. Oh, God. Hang on a second, will you, Dave? I mean, I know the name, really. It's Sam, Dave. I know it. Oh, Sam. How many Sams you know? Oh, God. Sammy Spiro, Dave. That's who it is, old Sammy Spiro. Well, let's not quibble about pronunciation, Dave. What is it, Spiro? All right, Spiro. We'll settle for that. I don't know, fella. I don't get it. Oh, that's good. I'm glad to hear that. Not so hot, Dave. I'm a little under the weather from last night's party. I have this little headache in my left eye. That's what I call you up to thank you for. That wonderful party you threw last night. Of course, we brought our own liquor, but you provided the electricity, and you should be thanked for that. Tell me, Dave, did I have a good time? No, I don't know, Dave. Well, at a certain point of the evening, everything's a complete blank. A few minutes after I arrive. What did I do? What? Oh, no. Oh, God. Oh, boy. Oh, gee, I'm sorry, Dave. The whole window, eh? You just come right out, huh? Yeah, that's a picture window, too, isn't it, Dave?
It's a lucky thing there was nobody walking under it at the time, huh?
Oh. Got him edgewise, huh? Oh, well, they'll put them back together, Dave. Those medical people are... Gee, Dave, I can't imagine how I managed to break a window. I don't have any cuts or bruises on my hands. How'd I break the window? I see. Were you very fond of that cat? Gee, those things are supposed to land on their feet, aren't they, Dave? Poor little fella. How did I manage to do that? Oh, yeah, yeah, I get the picture. Oh, gee, I must have been playing some sort of stupid game there or something. What was I doing? I see, and I guess the window was Goliath. Well, gee, Dave, naturally, I'll do my best to repair your window. That's picture window, right? Yeah, well, it'll take a lot of wood. Dave, I wonder if your mind would change the subject to something a little more pleasant, if you don't mind. Tell me, did your wife enjoy the party? What do you mean, I ought to know? I did not. I did not. Oh, David, it was a long, hard party, Dave. The curtain watchers may have gotten tired and stretched out for a bit. Well, I thought it was a pile of clothing, Dave. And Dave, you know how I feel about Myrna. Why, I love your wife. Now, that isn't what I meant, Dave. I mean, I love your wife the same way I love you. That's not what I meant either. I hardly think it's necessary for you to warn me to keep my hands off you, too. What? No, Ken. Right off the hinges, huh? The whole damn door. You think you can get along without it, Dave? That's right. Your bathroom is right off your kitchen. Yeah, sorry about that. Dave, when you come right down to it, the only real damage I caused was a broken window and a broken door, right? No, I won't forget the cat, Dave. Thank you very much.
Dave, in the shape I was in, it's lucky the only thing I threw through the window was a cat, huh?
Oh, really? Who? Oh, God. I hope she wasn't angry. That's swell. She always was a pretty good sport, your mother. Listen, Dave, the reason I'm calling, I'm having these business associates in town for the weekend, and I'd like to throw this little shindig on them. You know how small my place is. So I was wondering if I could use your place for a few hours Saturday night. Know what I mean? A few drinks, couple of laughs, you know. Dave? Dave? Come on, boy, pull yourself together over there. Dave, stop that now. I can't bear to hear a man cry. Dave? Dave? Now, Dave?